North Korea is really mistaken if it thinks it's improving its security by turning in the direction of nuclear weapons.
In October 2002, U.S. Assistant Secretary of State James Kelly confronted North Korean officials about intelligence showing the country had a secret uranium enrichment program. North Korea's unapologetic response and anger in Washington led to the collapse of the agreed framework. While there are rumors of secret enrichment sites across North Korea, only one site is confirmed. The Centrifuge Hall is part of an extensive complex at the heart of North Korea's nuclear program, the Yongbyon Nuclear Research Center, which also houses the country's plutonium production reactor and a light water power reactor. The enrichment site originally functioned as a fuel fabrication complex, making Magnox-style fuel rods for an adjacent 5-megawatt plutonium production reactor. The building that now houses the enrichment plant was disabled under U.S. supervision in accordance with the Six-Party Talks September 2005 joint statement. However, North Korea began new construction on the site in April 2009, after ejecting International Atomic Energy Agency inspectors. Subsequent satellite images revealed a new bright blue roof and construction on several buildings in the complex. In November 2010, Siegfried Hecker and two of his colleagues from Stanford University visited the Yongbyon Nuclear Research Center. As Hecker entered the control room, he was stunned to find an ultra-modern clean centrifuge plant in place of the disabled fuel fabrication facility he had visited 2 years earlier. North Korea's chief process engineer told the Americans that the facility contained 2,000 centrifuges in 6 cascades. Hecker estimated the centrifuges to be 8 inches in diameter and 6 feet tall, with smooth aluminum casings, making them similar to Pakistan's P2 centrifuges. After the Americans' 2010 visit, North Korea continued to refurbish and expand its enrichment facilities. This included approximately doubling the floor space of the centrifuge hall in 2013. North Korea's rapid modification and expansion of its uranium enrichment facilities is troubling, especially because centrifuge enrichment facilities are so difficult to detect and monitor. Scientists at Yongbyon boasted that they produced the centrifuges indigenously, perhaps using specialized equipment known as CNC machines and materials procured abroad. North Korea claims that its enrichment program is intended to provide fuel for the adjacent light water reactor. However, the facility could also be used to produce highly enriched uranium for North Korea's nuclear weapons program.